this one called?
I can't remember. Ordeal to get here.
Yeah.
This was the mum of that one and that one.
Yeah,
aren't you?
Oh, that. That wasn't Duchess, was it?
Oh yeah, one is Duchess, one is Bear.
And this is the mum, but that.
And this is Tizzy or Tibby or Tizzy.
That wasn't Duchess though, is it? Come on, hike up, hike up, come on. Come on, dogs, hike up.
The slowest part of the track is always so much.
A lot to do with starting these husky ridings. I've always had worse than dogs like the lurches and the pointers, like you saw in the kennel there.
Yeah.
And that's what really started me off in working dogs. I really enjoy seeing them, what they meant to do.
Yeah.
Like when I started doing this, it was brilliant seeing these huskies. Like, you've never known a dog like it. They love working so much.
Yeah.
So I think it's a bit bumpy across here.
Whoa!
Hike up! Come on in! Hike up! Hike up! Just speed up a little bit, smooth, honey. Hike up! Come on!
Ever had anyone fall out?
No, never had anyone fall out, but now you said that, that is the first time for everything. Are you guys I rotate which dogs go out twice a day.
Yeah.
But I've got certain dogs that I take out in the morning and certain dogs that I only take out in the afternoon, and the really good ones, Salah, are the only ones that go out twice a day.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would.
Salah, up. Come on. What are you doing? Don't do it again. Hike up. Eagle Heights opened at the Bird of Prey Centre.
Right.
And my dad, he was a plumber before he started this.
Wow.
And he always had an interest in birds of prey.
Yeah.
And anyway, when he got his plumbing job, he got loads of new birds and stuff. And then we're building all this stuff in our back garden. And then he started going around to do school talks and things.
Yeah.
And then found a site to open Eagle Heights. Now, Eagle Heights is on top of this hill, purely for flying eagles. And it's because of all the valleys are eagles to soar like wild eagles, and they go up so high some days that you can't even see them.
Wow.
And the only reason you know they're above the centre is because of the transmitter on them.
Wow, that's amazing.
It is good, and we do all the shows and stuff with them. And yeah, and then it just grew into a wildlife park. And a few years ago we got our first chickens. About 6 years ago we got our first meerkats and stuff. Changing all the time, and we were offered white lions, but it's too expensive to build their enclosure for a little place like us, to be honest. We wouldn't get them unless we could build them with like decent enclosure, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So unfortunately we're not going to get those.
Do you work with all the other animals?
Yeah, in the summer my job is I mainly do all the shows. And I trained the cheetah last year for running the show and stuff. And again, not only do wolves, but he's the only cheetah that comes out in front of the public.
Right.
And he raised over £1,600 for the cheetah conservation in Africa.
Aww.
So he's like a little mascot, like the English ambassador, we call him.
And is this place self-sufficient on the money
yeah,
you get
yeah,
in? Or?
It's actually not a charity, it's a business.
Yeah.
So we have to earn all our own money to stay open and do the work that we do and stuff.
Yeah.
And that's why I was saying these experience days are our main source of income in the winter, because we just don't really get any visitors once it starts getting cold and wet, to be honest.
Yeah. This was Alpha, and I can't remember what this was called, but he's mad. He's a bit daft. He's a bit silly. He likes running. But this was Clever.
That's a nutter.